Hey, what's going on guys, Wingsman here and welcome back to another restaurant tutorial. And today guys, I'm gonna be showing you how to make this really cool and simple troll door in Minecraft Bedrock Edition. So if you guys are excited for that, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you're new. And without further ado, let's get right into today's video. You may be asking, why is this a troll door? It's just a simple 3x3 door, there is nothing unusual. That's exactly what we want people to think. This is just an ordinary 3x3 door, but behind it we have a little trap in form of 9 dispensers that are gonna shoot arrows at you really rapidly. If you don't have any armor, this can definitely kill you. You guys probably just want to see this in action, so when I press this lever, the door is going to open and then the arrows are gonna start shooting at us really rapidly, so let's just test it out. You can see the arrows are just gonna start shooting at us, and again, if you don't have any armor, this is definitely going to kill you. You can see they're just gonna go on and on as long as we have the arrows in them. And of course, to stop it, we need to close the door, and you can see the arrows are gonna stop shooting. But you can see, since I was not in survival, all of the arrows are gonna end up right here. So you can see this amount of the arrows can definitely kill you, and this is a really easy contraption to set up. All we have at the back is just 9 dispensers with a simple observer clock right here. When the two faces of the observer meet, it's going to start the clock, and they're just gonna keep sending the signal, and we basically have that going into some of the dispensers right here. And of course, you can use any kind of the door that you want. I'm using the 3x3 piston door that I showed you in one of my previous videos, which was the red button activation system. If you want to check that video out, you can click in the top right corner right now. But with that said, I'm going to show you how to make this right now. So the blocks we're going to need for this are some block of our choice for the door, dispensers for the little troll with the arrows, we're going to need some observers, sticky pistons, redstone block, a redstone dust, redstone repeater, some redstone torches, some slabs, and of course a lever to activate our door. So the first thing we need to do is actually build our door. I'm just gonna go 2 blocks away from the ground and have the first double piston extender right here, since we're making the 3x3 door. Then we're gonna have a little rim of the blocks for choice going around just like so. And now it's time to put in our sticky pistons. Again, you don't have to use this design of the door. I have a lot of the other doors that you can just use and build them up here and skip to the video where we do all the dispensers. But for this tutorial, I'm gonna be going for this 3x3 door. We're gonna have the first sticky piston over here going into this block right here in the corner over here where these two blocks meet. Then for these blocks, we're just gonna have these sticky pistons over here pointing into them, and we can basically destroy this block right there. For the top middle block, we're going to need another double piston extender, so we are just gonna build 3 blocks out and have 2 of them facing over here into this block, and of course we can destroy the one on the top. For this side, we're basically gonna do the same thing over here with 3 of the sticky pistons, so just go ahead and do something like this. Okay, just place them over here pointing into these blocks over here, so 1, 2, and 3, and of course you can destroy that one right there. Now that we have the outline of the pistons, it's time to actually connect them with redstone. We're gonna work our way from the bottom and basically go around. Since this is the one wide piston door, we're gonna start off by placing a block right here and having a redstone torch right there next to our double piston extender at the bottom. Then from that torch, go ahead and build 2 more blocks out with 2 pieces of the redstone like that. From this block, we're gonna need to create a little torch tower, so you have a torch on top of it and on the back right here. Then go ahead and place the block for choice on top of that, just like so. And have another torch over here at this block, and place another block of your choice just like so. Then grab yourself this sticky piston and have it going from this torch right here with the block of your choice right there. Then over here we need to have an observer that's pointing into this sticky piston right here, just like so. And have 2 of the repeaters, one going into this piston without a delay, and another going into that with max stick delay, just like so. Then go ahead, grab yourself the block for choice and place it right there. Then we can basically connect these sticky pistons with the redstone dust just going like so. We're going to need a slab over here, bring it over and lower it by 1 just like that. That way we're gonna be able to actually place the redstone on it and have another one right over here with the block on top of the piston, and you can see it's going to activate. Then grab yourself the observer, have one over here pointing into this sticky piston with the redstone dust right there. Then go ahead, grab yourself some block for choice and have 2 of the blocks over here and another one on top of that sticky piston. And over here we need 2 of the repeaters on max stick delay. Then we basically need to bring this redstone dust over right over here. So what we're gonna do is basically have a redstone dust right there, have this slab over here, lower it by 1 and just like so. And we can basically go ahead and place the restaurant right there, another slab over here, and you can see that's gonna get connected. Then go ahead and create a little staircase using some block for choice over here, going to this piston right there. So just go ahead and do something like that. You can basically grab yourself the redstone and bring it all the way down. Right here from this block, we need to have another redstone repeater going into the double piston extender right there and have it on max stick delay just like that. Then over here from this block, we're actually gonna need a sticky piston pointing down. We need to destroy these two blocks right here and have the sticky piston pointing down with the redstone block right there, and have another block over here with the piece of redstone dust. You can see all of them are gonna get connected. We can destroy that block right there because we don't need it. And to finish the 3x3 door, what we need to do is grab ourselves the observer, have it right here going down from the bottom piston. Go ahead, grab ourselves some block for choice and place three of them just like so. I have another block right over here, and we can basically lead the redstone over here into that block, and we are pretty much done. In order to actually open the door, we need to deactivate this torch over here, so we're just gonna use a lever, and you can see the door is going to open. The next step is to actually build a little platform for us to stand on, so just go ahead and cover up the redstone. What we can do now, since this is the actual troll door, we can have the lever over here on plain sight. We can just go over here underneath and basically have a sticky piston pointing down with the redstone block over here. So you can see once we actually activate the lever, we're gonna get the signal right here from the actual redstone block. We can basically lead that right over here into a redstone torch. So you can see when we actually press it, the door should hopefully open up. And this is where the rest of the plan comes in. We are gonna have our wall of the dispensers one block away from the actual door, so just go ahead and build a little block over here, and we can basically put the 3x3 of the dispensers right over here. Just go ahead and place them like that, and we are gonna finish the wall over here, and then from that redstone block over here at the bottom, we're basically gonna connect it to the dispensers. But before we do that, we're gonna have the redstone that we need to actually have the arrows dispensed. So all we have to do to power all of the dispensers is power these blocks over here for the bottom room, then we can power these dispensers right here, and to hook up the top one, we basically need to have this row over here and power the blocks on top of them. So what we're gonna do is basically build some of the blocks out over here, just like so. We just need like a 2x2 platform, nothing too big. What we're gonna do is have the repeaters going into the bottom blocks over here and connect them with the redstone dust over here. Then we are basically gonna do the same on this row over here. So just go ahead and basically have a block over here with the on top of the redstone dust. And basically go ahead and sneak so that way you can place all of the blocks over here on top of the redstone. And basically repeat the same process. We need the repeaters with the redstone dust right there. And again, go ahead and do the same thing. Just go ahead and create a 2x2 platform on top of the previous redstone that you built. Then just go ahead and of course have the repeaters right here and the redstone dust on the other side. We can basically connect that using some block for choice right over here. So go ahead, have the redstone right there, and we can basically create a little staircase. And we're gonna do the same on the other side as well. So just go ahead and do something like this, and we can bring another block over here and basically connect all of that with redstone. And before we bring the redstone over from right there, we need to do one last thing. We need to have another block right there with the repeater pointing into that redstone dust, because we're gonna be using the observer clock, and sometimes that can be a little bit finicky, because even though they're not supposed to stop, sometimes they're just gonna stop the redstone for no reason. But what we need to do is have a block right there, and you can see the observer face right here. In order to make it blinking, we need to have another observer face to touch it, and you can see it's gonna start blinking over here. And the way we're gonna do this automatically with the actual lever and the actual door, and that's really simple to do. We just need to shift it one block over here to the side, and we need to have a little sticky piston that's gonna push it when we actually press the lever. And basically all we have to do is bring the redstone to this point, so we're just gonna create a little staircase over here, and we can basically lead the redstone all the way over here. So just go ahead and do something like this, and we can hook it up to this piece of the redstone right here, and just go ahead and do something like this, bring all of the redstone over, and you can see that it's going to activate. So what we have to do is basically deactivate this over here, just like so. And you can see the door is going to close, and you can fill it up with the arrows, and everyone that opens it is gonna get about 1000 arrows in their face. But that's gonna have to do it for today's video. If you guys have enjoyed it, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you're new. If you think any of your friends would enjoy this type of content, make sure to share it with them. But as always, I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.